at the 82nd floor where Terry and Mary was hiding with the staffs of the building, an argument erupted among them. They were deciding whether to stay put in the office till help comes or find a way to get out of the building without being detected by the monsters. Most of them objected to the notion of leaving the office, for there were monsters everywhere, in which Terry tried to make them see his point of view that staying in the office was more risky, for these monsters also come through the ceiling of the building and they attack. Leaving the rest behind, Terry, Mary, Jackson and Gabrielle decided to find a way to escape from the building, but all the doors were jammed and blocked. Worst of all, they could hear the voices of people dying in pain. There were dead bodies everywhere, and some of those bodies were still breathing but at the point of death. When they got to the 75th floor, they saw the strangest thing you could ever imagine, as the monsters were dragging and forcing those who were still alive to their master as they chant and praise his name, in which their master was sucking the blood out of the living presented to it, a kind of a forceful initiation against their will. What was more shocking to them was seeing their friends Ashley, Gavin and Rachel being forced towards their master. Terry called out Gavin to dash and run through the entrance on his right, but they were too terrified to do so, as one of the monsters leading the living to its master noticed a sound from Terry's direction, walked up to drag a half-dead body on the floor by the door, and it slammed the door shut. Mary suggested to Terry that they should find a way to help their friends, but he let her know that there was nothing he can do to help them. They were stuck, for most of the doors were locked and the lift had stopped working, so it was a dead end. Mary, whose father is the head architect of the building, suggested they go upstairs to her father's office and find the master keys that could open doors. The police were ready to bust into the building as the requested expert who knows the architectural layout of the building arrived and was complaining about the impromptu call. Now, the SWAT team had body cameras on them, so it will be possible for the deputy director of the FBI to see what was going on inside the building. As they moved into the building, they met a surprise as the monsters came out of nowhere and attacked the SWAT team before they could even pull a trigger. They ripped them to shreds and devoured them as the deputy director watched as his men fall to their death. With no lights in the building, it was a bit difficult to locate the office of Mary's father. When they eventually got there, they couldn't find the master key, for it was nowhere to be found. Terry had a better idea, for he decided to go through the computer of Mary's father, which had the schematics and blueprint of the Empire State Building. Then he synced it into his phone. Mary was scared and weak to her knees, as Terry urged and encouraged her to be strong. As fate would have it, Terry discovered a way out of the building through the schematics of the building he synced into his phone. Their master's hunger was insatiable, for it wants to feed more on the blood of the living, as the monsters forced those who are still alive to eat. Gavin, Ashley and Rachel were next, and according to Terry, the entrance to their right was a way for them to escape. As they ventured to escape, they were stopped by the monsters and ruthlessly punished for their insubordination. Even with what they saw through the body cameras from the SWAT team that were attacked, they were still in belief that they were dealing with well-trained terrorists, and snipers were in position opposite the Empire State Building. Now, the professor, who is an expert and the head architect of the building, suggested that sprinklers in the building can be used to gas the terrorists to submission, but the deputy officer objected to that idea, for the Empire State Building was no small building, and moreover, he doesn't have the capability to arrange for a large quantity of nerve gas. On the recording they got from the body cameras, they heard the monsters speak in some foreign language they were unable to decipher, but with the help of a linguistic language expert, they discovered that they were speaking a deep-rooted ancient Native American language, which was spoken by Mohawks, who were particularly not afraid of heights and were also part of those who built the skyscraper. In fact, those who speak this deep-rooted language were called man-eaters. On the 60th floor, Terry's brilliant idea of escaping was to go out through the windows and walk through the ramps on the side of the building. Now, the snipers on the other side of the building saw the four individuals making their escape on the ramps hanging on the side of the building. It was terrifying for them as they climbed down. And to make matters worse for them, they were being chased by the monsters. One of the monsters tried to attack Mary while Terry came to her defense and hit the monster. Gabrielle was hanging on the ramp as she was too afraid to jump, but her grip began to loosen, so she fell to her death, which devastated Jackson. The snipers began to shoot at the monsters to help them escape, but the bullets were ineffective. Noticing the help he was getting from the snipers, Terry quickly helped Mary down the ramps so she wouldn't face the same fate as Gabrielle. Unfortunately for Terry, one of the shot monsters rose from its undead position and attacked him. With the help of the snipers, it was shot in the head. Terry urged Jackson, whom was still shocked that Gabrielle is dead, to hurry up, for the monsters were closing in on them. Suddenly, there was an explosion which was triggered by a shot from one of the snipers, whom shot at a cylinder positioned in one of the ramps of the building, which eventually killed and burned the monsters to ashes. Due to the commotion outside at the 49th floor, they decided to go back inside, and they found a dead body of a police officer and realized he still had his walkie-talkie. Now, the deputy director of the FBI dig deeper into the terrorists and their language, in which they discovered that their language was an ancient dialect used for initiation, which revealed them confessing that they were the chosen ones of Hamatsa. The revelation they acquired went further on this individual as a cult, and not just any ordinary cult, but a cult that worships a vampire god called Utilunta, who enslaves its victims by sucking their blood, and if they are lucky enough, they become vampires. For these individuals that worship Utilunta are woken from death and with great power take over the world. Now, with the evidence at hand, the deputy director of the FBI can now see that they were not dealing with terrorists or humans, but vampires. Jackson was distraught, for the love of his life was gone. He couldn't believe it. As Terry tried to console him, Mary tried to communicate with the police outside the building with the walkie-talkie they found on the dead police officer, making them know that they were surrounded by dead bodies. After sucking the blood out of the living during the initiation, Utilunta turned them into vampires, including Terry and Mary's friends, and commanded them to go on the attack.